Child of God, welcome to your Father's house. And we're continuing to read from Paul's letter to the Philippians. Remember, it's written from a prison cell. And Paul is facing trial and ultimately execution. But he's writing to his friends and his heart is full. Yes, he says, I'm rejoicing and I will continue to rejoice, for I know that through your prayers and the help of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, this will turn out for my deliverance. It is my eager expectation and hope that I will not be put to shame in any way, but that by speaking with all boldness, Christ will be exalted now in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, to live is Christ, and to die is gain. If I am to live in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I don't know which to prefer. I'm hard-pressed between the two. My desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that's far better. But to remain in the flesh is more necessary for you. Since I'm convinced of this, I know that I will remain and continue with all of you for your progress and your joy and faith, so that I may share abundantly in your boasting in Christ Jesus when I come to you again. And now our prayer. Father, oh Father, we think of Paul in that prison cell, putting the needs of others before himself. Lord, do you have a task for us in our enforced separation? Do you have a task for me? Should I be putting my own needs aside and hearing your voice calling me to some extra action, some extra love? Help us, dear Lord, to follow Jesus in this. In his name, amen.